Hello and welcome everyone to the War Thunder game. My name is IronRifle, and in today's video, well, there is a couple of things that I would like to address, especially the Genshin Entertainment. One thing being the last night giveaway of the display. The A26 C45 Invader. Basically is the A20G on steroids, so just to clarify that. But the other thing is how they did give out the codes, and the thing was, there is the Facebook page of the War Thunder, there is also their homepage, thewarthunder.com, and they did post it on the Facebook. 10 premium codes, each like 10 to 15 minutes, and the first one who grab it gets the aircraft. And there wouldn't be anything wrong about it, except for the fact that, well, I did have a chance to refresh the page when the post was made, because on the Facebook it was made a second ago underneath the post, and I did select not the first, not the third, but like the sixth or the fifth code that there was. Take it to the web page, paste it to the redeem key. I did press the redeem, and nothing happened. The code was already redeemed. So I did think to myself, well, okay, let's try it again. After the second try, I was a bit frustrated, to say the least, and most of the Facebook users were also pissed off about it. But then I did thought to myself, well, maybe someone is using some sort of macro to just copy the code, go to the certain, go to the redeem code, redeem it, and he do have it. So thankfully, I am using the Razor gear, the Razor Naga, and also the X7 keyboard, not by Razor. And I did set up the macro that pretty much whenever I select something and press the one key, it did went to the other screen in the matter of, well, milliseconds, face the code, and press the redeem. And it was done in like, I don't know, 1 second? Half of the second? It was almost instantly. And I waited for the new codes. There was the couple of surprise codes, like find in the key combination the name of the American plane or the German plane or something like that. But then at the end they did release 50 codes. It was the last release that they did release 50 codes. I did select first one, press my macro button, already taken. Select randomly from the list, press the button, taken. Third, taken. So what I must say is, I don't know how they are doing it, or maybe you guys will know how to do it, to instantly copy and paste the key from your browser to your other window in the browser and redeem it. I have absolutely no idea. But, well, the only one thing that is left after this promotion of the War Thunder is a bad taste, and I must say most of the people will probably agree with me that this is not the way to get new subscribers, to get new players into the game, or to even promote. Well, it is a good thing to promote your Facebook page, but well, it's a game on, not on the Facebook, so stop with the Facebook crap. if you do want to give out the free codes for the invader or for any other planes that there is in the game, like the KI-61, all the American, all the nations do have some premium aircrafts. If you do want Genjin, if you do want to give them out, set a set rules for the tournament, like the best game or the best score or something like that, that each player can do, and then the best guy will win it. Not the one closest to the server or someone with the amazing reflexes just to copy and paste instantly and redeem the codes, because for me that is not something to go for. But enough of me complaining right now. There is one thing I do want to show you, and it is considering my British Air Force. Yes, I know, again, the British, but I do love those planes so much, I cannot live without them. And to be perfectly honest with you, I do have more fun flying the British right now up to tier 6. As you can see, my whole lineup is up to tier 6. I'm having so much fun, and I do rarely have a bad game, but today I do want to show you a almost 15 kills mission. I would say almost, because I did score the last kill in the last after the battle results. I was charging onto the, I believe it was the Lag 3 or some of the Russian planes, and it didn't add it to the score. But yet again, a 14 kill mission. It was done on the live stream. There is also the highlight on the Twitch, and also just a reminder, I am trying to stream every day from Monday till Friday, 8-9 p.m. GMT plus 1. There will be a description and the link to my Twitch TV channel in the description of the video, so you can check that out and come join me. Because, well, I do usually fly with the Primal, because he was generous enough to lend me his TeamSpeak, and he's teaching me the ways of the DayZ survivor. But that is another story. I did fly this mission with him. It was the first, I believe it was the first or the second mission that we flew that evening. And I do want to show you this, never ever to give up. That's the worst thing you can do, and I do hate players that come into the battle with just one plane, or they are just flying one plane, like the very famous or infamous pilots of the Yak-90, who are just going into the battle, they flying this just one aircraft, and if they are got shut down, they are just quitting the battle. That's not the way you're supposed to play. You do get some of the options here to set up your lineup. And if you are choosing like 4 aircrafts, 5 aircrafts, 10 aircrafts, go with them. Fly the freaking mission to the end. I know I'm running the premium account, so that's something different. Because I am earning a bit more. But for all of you that don't have the premium account, believe me, it is possible to level up, to get the lions, and still have loads of fun onto this game. By the way, I don't know if you all noticed that, but after last update, or maybe few before that, you can do something that was unable. Well, we weren't unable to do before, which is the send crew on the holiday. Whenever you select it, you do have an empty slot in here, and effectively, as you can see, I can still fly my troll reserve aircraft here up to tier 1 lineup from the Russian. So if you do were wondering where the last crew go, well, they are on holiday. Just one thing in short, because, well, I did get some questions about how can I dispose of my crew, so here it is, you can also do it. And well, enough of me talking right now, so let's go, let's jump on to the mission. One thing though, first three kills, I don't know why it didn't record, but the after that, it's everything is recorded except for the sound. I don't know, maybe it's just me that is breaking some of the my software when I'm recording it, or it was muted by some odd reason. I don't know, I will put some music into the background. And yeah, let's go, let's see the mission.
Thank you.
So, as you do see, 14, almost 15 kills mission. And, yeah. So, the Memorial Day, in terms of the Genjin Entertainment, will be remembered for its big fail. Those couple of hundred people, well, couple of hundred people, yeah, something like that, will have a good memories because they were the first to get the invader, the first one to activate the code, and they didn't have a lag or anything, and they did refresh this page in time. So, yeah, good for you. But for everyone else, I do believe you probably will be sharing my point of view that it was, well, let's say a bit unfair, but I don't care. I will get this plane eventually because, well, I do think that they will put it into the store for some expansion pack or for some other mission packs maybe, and it will be available at some point. So if they're giving it away, okay, that's fine with me. Sooner or later it will be available for Golden Eagles or so for the real money. And until then, bye bye invader. Let's get back onto the topic. So, just to finishing off the video, I would like to thank you all for watching, for tuning in. Remember about subscribing to my channel. Also visit me on Twitch. I do sometimes stream other games other than the War Thunder. It might be World of Tanks, it might be the Star Wars The Old Republic, it may be the World of Tanks, but main focus would be on the War Thunder, because, well, I do like this game, and I know all of you guys also like this game. So, not to getting too ahead of myself, again, thanks for watching, thanks for tuning in, and I do hope to see you all next time, but until then, Iron Rifle out.